So over and over again, we have seen that there is in this country another power than that which has its seat at Westminster. The City of London, a convenient term for a collection of financial interests, is able to assert itself against the government of the country. Those who control money can pursue a policy at home and abroad, contrary to that which has been decided by the people.
Few were aware how this market functioned. Trusts are the basic building block of Anglo-Saxon secrecy, and they form the basis from which complex offshore structures are created. Their aim was to create offshore centres with strong secrecy legislation in order to attract capital from across the globe. Secrecy jurisdictions are heavily used for fraudulent and grey area financial activities, areas where secrecy is not just desirable, but a necessity. There are numerous variations of trusts and offshore secrecy structures. There are offshore lawyers whose work entails the creation of ever more complex and obscure structures. The aim of these structures is to hide the identity of the owners of offshore assets and allow offshore wealth to be recycled back into global markets.
This system is really protecting the few people that are having benefit from it. We need the citizens to understand what is happening, that they are the ones who is carrying the burden, and that some individuals having the power are exonerating themselves. Ordinary people are paying taxes, rich people are not. So this is inequality, and it is leading up to populism, because it shows so clearly that the people today leading the world are not able to take care of the interest of ordinary people.
The City of London, London's financial district, is a peculiar place. It has been called a city within a city, a state within a state. It is run by an organization called the City of London Corporation, a private company that performs all the functions of a local council with a private police force and private courts.
The City of London has long had this curious legal status because back in 1066, when William the Conqueror came over, the city was one of the only portions of England that he failed to conquer, and he struck a deal with the city in 1067 that allowed them to continue functioning.
To this day, the City of London is exempt from numerous laws that govern the rest of Britain. Its political system derives from the Middle Ages. The city's electorate is dominated not by its residents, but by the private businesses operating within the city. Its Lord Mayor is selected by the heads of medieval guilds. This is a film about how Britain transformed from a colonial power to a modern financial power, and how this transformation has shaped the world we live in.
The only thing that could change this is to have a public accessible register of the beneficial ownership of trusts and of all kinds of companies. It is easy